Jim, I really got in touch with my inner self today.
Really?
I guess that means I need to start buying double ply toilet paper.
Oh, no.
This is the Woody and Jim Show podcast, over 1,000 episodes strong. A daily recap of everything you missed.
So bad.
We tell terrible jokes back and forth, and the first person to laugh loses the game.
So we have to tell jokes and not laugh at each other's jokes.
Usually it's just a test of wills, and eventually you get worn down and somebody laughs.
Yes.
All right.
Zach and Ricki get to laugh all they want and criticize.
Yes.
Criticize, that's my favorite part.
Yeah, that's mostly what we do.
Sometimes
we
have to stop and explain the joke to Zach.
I know, sometimes the funniest part is like three jokes later, Zach gets one of the previous jokes.
It takes a minute sometimes.
The delayed laughter. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Ricki, who should go first?
Jim, you go first.
All right. Are you ready?
Yes. Please bring on the serious Woody and Jim joke-off music. Why is Sunday stronger than Monday? Because Monday is a weekday.
That's so sad.
You know, Jim, I tell everybody about the benefits of dried grapes.
Really?
It's all about raising awareness.
I love Raisin Bran.
Good for you. That's a great
good
story.
Good to know. Thank you so much.
Thanks for sharing. 6:30 is my favorite time on the clock.
How's that?
Hands down. It is. Just hands down.
Oh, an analog joke. Jim, if you think eggs...
Zach
just got it.
Zach and everyone under the age of 25. Zach, had no idea what this is about.
Who can't read the analog clock on his luxury car?
No,
that's right.
That's great.
Jim, if you think eggs are expensive, you should see chimneys. They are through the roof.
Oh.
They actually are.
Yes, they are.
Yes.
Accurate.
Yes.
Not funny, but accurate.
Why couldn't the bicycle stand up by itself, Woody?
Why, Jim?
It was too tired.
Oh.
These are getting worse and worse.
They are that.
Jim, my girlfriend thinks it's weird that I just stare at the window during violent thunderstorms. It'd be less weird if she just let me in.
Oh.
So now you're a stalker?
Yeah, I almost laughed. I almost laughed on that one. Okay, I've recovered.
Okay.
Did you hear the one about the kid who started a business tying shoelaces on the playground? It was a not-for-profit.
Cute.
That is cute.
Also really smart.
Jim, you hear about the guy who covered his groin with glitter?
No.
Pretty nuts.
Jim's trying very hard not to laugh.
Did you get that one? Did you get that one?
He was still stuck on the not-for-profit, and I was trying to motion to him.
Oh, the K-N-O-T.
Knots. That's what this was, Zach. Motion with my hands was tying a knot.
And the glittery groin means for pretty nuts.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, see, Zach wasn't concentrating on that one.
I know, he was distracted by the last joke.
And it still wasn't funny, though.
I actually was watching Ricki miming
trying to tie a knot
so she could explain it to Zach.
I tried really hard.
It was there was a little show going on.
It's a learning experience. All right.
Why did Beethoven get rid of his chickens?
Because
all they said was bok bok bok.
Oh,
a rival symphony writer. Did you hear the joke about experiencing deja vu?
No.
Did you hear the joke about experiencing deja vu? That was terrible.
That was
these
really
are bad.
These are the worst I think you guys have ever done.
Oh,
thank you.
They'll get worse. Don't worry. Don't worry.
What's the difference between a man wearing pajamas on a bicycle and a guy wearing a tuxedo on a unicycle?
I can't imagine.
A tire.
Jim, two men broke into a pharmacy and stole Viagra. Police say be on the lookout for two hardened criminals. Zach got
that one's kind of hard.
Yeah,
that's a good one.
It's been given the award of semi-funny.
Yeah.
My IQ test results came back.
Really?
Oh, did they?
They were negative.
Makes sense based on these jokes.
Jim, I haven't laughed once.
Jim, I met my girlfriend on the net. We're both terrible trapeze artists.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
He'll get that.
Painful.
What did you hear about the nurse who was chewed out by the doctor because she was absent without gauze?
Oh.
That was horrendous, Jim.
Ouch.
Yeah, that was a weapon of mass destruction.
These are hurtful. Like, oh.
Okay. Jim.
Step up our game. Let's do it.
If you want a job in the moisturizer business, the best advice is to apply daily.
Okay, almost. Okay. Almost.
The good one starts now.
That what did you shuffling through his cards of all of his jokes?
I really want to know what jokes made people laugh while they're listening.
That reminded me
car.
To put on lotion.
Okay, Woody, I got an email explaining how to read maps backwards.
Really?
It was spam.
Oh, maps backwards.
Yeah. That one took me a second, not going to lie.
Jim, what is the leading cause of dry skin?
I don't know.
Towels. God, no. You laugh at that one.
It was just so stupid.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, it was a combination of your joke and the fact that you mentioned moisturizer in the last joke, and Zach rubbing
started,
it all over his body.
I'm putting
he
lotion
just
on.
Like, that is a distraction. All right.
Jim laughed, and Zach gets the assist.
There's an asterisk. I'm going to take this up with the commissioner.
We will have another round of this just after 8 o'clock.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. Okay, you know somebody that lives a world away, but you still want to kiss them. A Chinese classroom has come out with something called the remote kiss device. It has little silicone lips on it, and it will measure the heat, the pressure, and your kiss.
Oh.
And then somebody who has the same device on another part of the planet can also they can activate it and kiss their phone.
Yo, I kind of love this.
No.
I just want to see somebody doing it.
I kind of love this. Like, if you're in a long-distance relationship, you know how like much better that would be for your relationship and like how much more intimate that you could be?
But the person's not really there.
Just, I mean, but it would feel like they're
there.
You're
kissing rubber lips.
I don't know.
It's a little weird.
I know feel like it would be special.
I know people that love their phone so much, they just want to kiss it.
They kiss it even the lips weren't there, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's just
that's
fun.
Wow. Ricki?
Red Lobster is doing something that I don't know how I feel about.
Mm-hmm. What?
They have launched their first line of frozen food products. So their Cheddar Bay biscuits are everywhere.
Yum.
Which is great.
That
so
is
love
good.
That.
That is good.
But
they're also launching Cheddar Bay biscuit shrimp, Cheddar Bay biscuit cod, coconut shrimp bites, and herb stuffed shrimp.
I'm here for all of these.
Really? I don't know.
I don't have a problem with any of those.
Mm. I don't know how I feel about frozen, already made, it feels like seafood, like it's
yeah, I'm here for it. Trader Joe's has like the most bomb versions of those, so I'm like, if Red Lobster is gonna release them, I will buy
me
it.
Out.
Mm. I don't even know if Red Lobster is actually not frozen already.
Okay, solid Ooh. Point. I don't know the last time I've even been to a Red Lobster though.
That's true.
Those biscuits are bomb, but everything else is iffy.
It's like a restaurant you go with your grandma.
Yeah, Jim.
Everybody's inspired by this high school cheerleader from Nebraska. Her name is Katrina, and she was going to the state finals with three other cheer members, and they were going to do a routine they had been practicing for months. And then just a few weeks before the states, they quit. The other three didn't, they couldn't go. They said like they had family reasons, whatever it was. And so the cheerleading coach said to this one girl who's a senior, well, we'll just go to states and we'll watch and we'll cheer them on and we'll learn stuff. And Katrina said, no, I want to dance. So she came up with her own solo dance routine and danced at states among all the other cheerleading squads.
Good for her.
No kidding.
And all the other squads were cheering for her. The whole place loved her.
Nice.
And while there's a little asterisk next to her competition because she didn't have a whole squad with her, she scored eighth in the competition, which is the highest her school has ever done.
Look
wow.
at her go.
Woody and Jim in the morning, 107.5 The River. Thanks for tuning in. All right, Ricki, explain dog poop jail.
Yeah, so I have an issue at my apartment complex.
Are you going to prison?
I'm not going to prison.
Stop getting so excited.
If I did go to
Zach's
prison.
Zach's secret dream has always been to go to prison.
Like we said, it would be dog poop prison, which is vastly different. Okay. It's mainly a fee that I have to pay.
Okay, so
which is also not fun.
Is this a rule about people picking up after their dogs?
Yes. So I live in an apartment complex where there's a lot of dogs. Uh-huh. Like, it's basically like a requirement for you to have a dog in order to live there.
And they have a limited place for them to go to the bathroom.
Yes, exactly. Unless you want to walk them around town, which you obviously can still do, but there's select areas that you can take them to.
Mm-hmm.
So I have this thing, though, where during the day, I will always pick up my dog's poop. No problem when I take him out for walks.
Right.
But if it's nighttime and I'm cold and I'm tired.
And there are no witnesses.
I'll leave it there.
Ricki Sanchez.
You're bad.
Yeah. It's cold and I'm tired and I don't want to do it. Also, like, you have to remember that this is me living in an apartment now, but we used to have a yard, so we would just let him go out.
Yeah, just open the back door and let him go do his business.
And then we would just have to clean it up, like, days later.
Right.
All at one time.
That is so messed up.
So I just leave it there.
Okay, so what about the other people that are also walking their dogs later after you, and then they step in your dog's poop because you were not responsible enough to pick it up?
If they're stepping in my dog's poop, they're walking in the wrong places. There's
the
grass? Walkway. There's a walkway that you're supposed to be on. But also, I'm not the only one that does this. So it's kind of become a problem.
Okay. So if everybody jumped off a cliff, would you?
Depends on the day, Jim.
How high the cliff was. Yeah, there's a lot of variables.
But a lot of people keep doing it now. I'm not the only one that does it.
So you started this.
I did not start it. Someone else did. I just followed their lead. But now it's such an issue that my apartment complex is concerned about the amount of dog poop that just keeps getting left outside. They, like, are threatening to check the dog poop.
I heard a lot of places are doing that where you actually have to give them a stool sample of your dog so they can DNA test it.
Okay, see, I didn't even know how it worked.
And they could tell whose poop that is.
And then if they find some other poop and there's a match, then they know who to find in the complex.
But how would they know that it's my dog's poop?
Wouldn't that be a choice
job? Because they're going to pick it up and test
it. Because everybody who has a dog has to submit a sample, and then they
we never submitted a sample.
Oh, then they have a file.
If they start that, then that could be an issue. Yeah.
How would they? That's insane.
Well, how would they do it? They would just go wherever you go at night. Yeah. That's how they get your dog sample.
I also feel like that's just a lot of money that they're wasting.
Or they'll probably pass it on to the renters, I'm sure.
Yeah, you're paying for it.
Oh, you're right. That might be the fine that they're talking about.
Yeah.
Well, you know what?
That's what you get.
If this does happen, if they do require you to give a dog poop sample so they can do DNA testing, give them your poop. Because while it's not impossible, it's unlikely that you yourself would go poop in the yard.
I think you're underestimating Ricki.
Okay.
You know, now that I don't have my own yard, I've stopped pooping in the yard.
After
so
a whole
correct.
Night of espresso martinis, it might happen.
But also,
I love an espresso martini.
Of course you do.
What kind of dog is Pee-wee again?
I'm not going to say now. I feel like they're going to know.
He's a small
Boston
dog.
Boston Terrier.
Yeah.
He's a small dog. There's no way that they have the same size poop. Like, they would know.
I'm a small person.
Yes.
He's a small dog.
Don't judge Ricki by her poop size.
Your logs have got to be larger than Pee Wee's.
Right.
I can chop them up. And it means I don't have to pay a fine for $300.
I'm never eating at your house again, knowing that you're chopping up your poop.
I didn't say I'm using utensils to do it. Plastic ones.
Hey, guess what that spatula was doing later? Oh my God.
Woody and Jim in the morning on 107.5 The River.
Ricki, a happy story involving one of our favorite people.
Dave Grohl. He is just absolutely amazing, and he just proves it constantly.
Mm-hmm.
He recently, when California got hit with those storms, and it froze like all of California. It was
pretty
so
much.
Cold there. He went and he decided that he was going to smoke barbecue for the homeless.
Aww.
So he went to a homeless shelter with his big barbecue pit.
Oh, yeah.
He seasoned all the meats. He had brisket, pork butt, ribs, all sorts of stuff that was delivered there. Seasoned all of it. let it sit and marinate because he was like, no, 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 we can't cook it yet. Like, right, we have to let it marinate this specific way.
Gotta do it right. Yeah.
He started at 3 in the afternoon, just like putting everything together, seasoning everything just right. Then he took turns with other people overnight, smoking the brisket and the pork butt and everything else all throughout the night. And then had it ready for everybody by 6 p.m. when they served dinner the next day. And he helped serve the dinner. He helped just take pictures and talk to everybody.
It.
Yes, he worked over 16 hours.
Wow.
Some That's so cool.
Some people would just write a check, but no, he does the work. He's with the people.
And everyone there said it was the best barbecue that they've ever had.
Oh, it must have smelled terrific for hours.
They said he put so much thought and love and effort into it, and that he had told everybody at the shelter that he loves to do this for everybody once he's done with music and everything like that. So once he's done in the studio or done with tour or anything like that, he likes to just smoke food for everyone and he likes to give back in that way.
I respect it.
A little local angle on that is I know he got a lot of his barbecue lessons.
Tips.
From Zach Brown, the Zach Brown Band here in Nashville.
Wow.
Love that.
That's right. They did a collab album together.
They did.
And it was really good, too, if you want to check it out.
Smoked, and he got some lessons.
No kidding.
You know, that makes sense.
Working the smoker.
Because he even wrote out little directions on how you cut brisket the correct way and everything like that for everybody that was serving. I'll post some pictures on Woody and Jim's show of just how sweet the whole process is. We love Dave Grohl.
That's definitely what's making us happy this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River. Zach, what you got?
So Justin Bieber announced his Justice World Tour, and then he put it on an indefinite hiatus by saying, after getting off stage, exhaustion overtook me. I realized that I needed to make my health the priority right now. After that happened, as of yesterday, he has now canceled all of his concert dates for the next 16 months.
Wow.
So there's no more Justin Bieber Justice World Tour. So if you do have tickets to the show, Ticketmaster did send out a like a notice saying that they canceled the show and that all of the money will be refunded.
Wait,
they got to be so mad.
All their money? Like, are they giving away all their
convenience fees?
Which is like half.
Probably not their convenience fees.
They're keeping all the money.
Just the ticket price, probably.
Yeah, Justin Bieber's giving back the money. We keeping ours.
Right. Yeah, so you're still out of like $130 for each ticket.
That for taxes, for convenience fees, all of that. And I was honestly looking forward to a show because he started like in Nashville that it was going to be at Nissan Stadium and then they moved it to Bridgestone Arena and then now it's just completely canceled.
And we sang every song at his last concert
We sure did. Every single one.
And we were in the nosebleeds and we were singing and dancing and having a great time.
I'm sure you were not alone.
Liam Hemsworth. So I guess he is officially suing Miley Cyrus for defaming him after the success of her song Flowers.
Right.
Because a lot of people are saying it's about him because he dedicated Bruno Mars' When I Was Your Man to her. And so it's kind of like a rebuttal back to that song.
But she never mentions him by name.
Yeah, so like how would he even know?
Yeah.
That's all speculation.
It's all speculation. She did release a song on the day that they started dating.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's literally all speculation, coincidence. I guess he was about to lose his contract with Netflix for the series The Witcher.
Oh, really?
All over this song. So he's suing her for defamation.
Sense. No, Netflix would not.
It's because they don't want
no
it anymore.
Way.
That's an excuse if they said it.
Yeah.
100%.
They can't be like, hi, there's a song that could possibly, maybe, in a way, be about you, so we're going to fire you.
He was going to replace Henry Cavill in the show, right? That's what I heard.
If you say so.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know if Zach is into the fantasy genre all that much.
Oh, come on. You know you are.
Except his fantasy about wanting to go to prison as a tourist.
That's different.
That's my only fantasy.
I'm not getting into that.
But yeah, I'm like, I think it's very weird and I'm intrigued to see like what actually happens in the court if he does end up suing her over the song. Because that would be like, Taylor Swift made her entire career off of writing about her exes.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, how are you going to sue them? And it's not defamation. She didn't say anything bad. She literally just said, I can live my own life, basically.
She didn't even name him.
No.
Yeah.
She was like, I don't need you. I can live my own life.
Taylor did name him.
She sure did.
Take that, Drew.
Yeah. Drew looks
Okay, stop.
Oh, that's very good.
Thank you so much. But if you want to see all the details.
I guess we don't need to see the Eras tour this year.
I know. We just got a 7-second version of it just now.
You're so welcome.
Beautiful. 107.5 The River with Woody and Jim in the morning. Obviously, we have not suffered enough, and neither have you. So let's have another Woody and Jim joke off.
The first person between Woody and I to laugh at the other's joke loses.
All right.
I got to tell you that Woody, I have not had success in this game lately.
Yeah.
So I think it might be because I'm not wearing my glasses. So I'm going to wear my glasses for this segment.
Okay, this doesn't count.
Must be the glasses.
This doesn't count. He's got googly eyes on his glasses. So it could be an unfair advantage going in.
No, it'll help me read.
I know. Those are great. You don't get credit for the laughter about the glasses, though.
That's true. All right. That's true.
All right, well, let's get into it. You want to start, Mr. Googly Eyes?
Sure.
All right, here we go.
Woody, why do cows have hooves? It is because they lactose.
Lactose.
Oh. You're just intolerant.
Lactose intolerant. Jim, I once had a summer job crushing Coke cans. I had to quit. It was just so depressing.
Oh.
Soda.
Yeah, soda. Soda.
Did you hear about the new air freshener they're developing that is mind-controlled?
No.
It makes sense if you think about it.
I like that.
That was
a good one. That was adorable.
Almost got you.
Jim, during the pandemic, I bought my pet duck a face mask. It wasn't anything fancy, but it fit the bill.
That was cute, but not funny.
Thank you. It's cute. All I can ask for is cute.
Woody, King Arthur didn't come up with the idea of having a round table.
Really?
It was one of his knights named Circumference.
That was close.
That almost got Woody.
That was close.
Woody was biting his lip.
You know, I like a good geometry joke.
Don't we all?
Who doesn't?
I can't even look at you, Jim, with the googly eyes on your glasses.
Those are adorable. Jim, did you hear about the big fire they had at the circus?
No.
It was intense.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yeah, it was.
That was not good.
Woody, I asked Siri why I was so bad with women.
Punchline hasn't even
happened
yet.
You didn't even get to the punchline yet, but Zach is in. He is all in.
So I asked Siri why I was so bad with women.
Yeah.
And she said, "This is Alexa, you moron."
That was a good one.
All right.
That was a good one.
Okay. Googly Eye Jim has won round number two.
He was right. It was the glasses.
It was the glasses and the Siri joke.
Yeah. Okay, so you want to do a little more?
Yeah.
Okay.
We will take a little break. Refresh our jokes and come back for the tiebreaker round.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. Zach.
Well, starting tomorrow, there's a new menu item at Chipotle.
Yeah.
It's the fajita quesadilla.
That sounds delightful.
Which sounds bomb. So it has like steak fajita with roasted corn salsa, the tomato chili salsa, sour cream. And I'm like, yes, I need this right this second.
Sold.
You can do steak, chicken, carnitas, literally any of the meats that you want in the quesadilla.
Sounds great.
I'm going tomorrow. Period.
Lunch date.
Yep. Jim?
Tom Brady officially retired, and he's thinking about doing something that his inner circle is very worried about.
Hmm.
Apparently, Tom, you know, was very taken with the laughs he was getting on the set of 80 for Brady. Movie with Tomlin and all those.
Jane Fonda.
Yeah. Apparently, Yahoo News and Radar Online are quoting sources that said, quote, "The ladies were super nice to him, and he did a nice job reading professionally written material in a small part. But he'll be playing in a whole different league if he takes up the stand-up stage, which they say he wants to do."
Oh,
so we
Jesus.
Might see Tom Brady at Zany's?
Possibly. Yeah.
The sad part is people will buy tickets.
Oh, yeah.
So he'll make a lot of money.
He doesn't even have to be funny or tell a joke. Just show up.
Yeah.
Apparently, his friends say, like, He does a funny impression of his former teammate, Rob Gronkowski, and he does a funny Boston accent, but people laugh kind of like a mom laughs at their kids.
Right. It's a pity laugh.
When, yeah.
When kids want to perform a skit they wrote for mom and dad.
Yeah. So he's a great quarterback, but
ew. Eek.
Yeah. Ricki.
So there's a new type of relationship with a new term that I actually support.
Okay.
It's an expirationship. So you go into this relationship with somebody knowing exactly what you want out of your partner for the time being.
Yeah.
And then you basically have an end date set up of like, okay, and then when this time comes, we're going to break up.
Oh, well, that's kind of like a summer thing. Like if you're
somewhere. Yeah, like a fling.
Yeah.
But it just like is right up front. Like you both agree that this is an expirationship. We're only going to do this for the summer or whatever it might be.
Yep.
And like come September, we're done.
Right.
And I kind of think it's a good idea.
I mean, I agree, especially around cuffing season. Like you need a date to Thanksgiving and Christmas to be around your family.
When it's cold and you want to cuddle.
Yeah.
And if it goes past that, it goes past that. But you go into it knowing that it's just got an expiration date on it.
It's like old milk.
And
now the moment that most of the people in this room have been waiting for, the final Woody and Jim joke off.
For today.
Not for all time. Oh, it'll come back. You know it.
Jim has his googly eyes on his glasses. Mm-hmm. If you want to see them, I posted them on our Instagram story. It's at Woody and Jim Show. You can see how insane he looks with these on.
This is my intimidation laugh glasses.
That's right. Jim got a little helping hand from Party City.
All right, so Jim started last time. Woody, that means you have to start this time.
Okay, let us begin. First one to laugh loses. Here we go. Jim, when I get to work, first thing I do is go hide.
Really?
Because we all know that good employees are hard to find.
That almost got me.
Zach got a smirk. I got a smirk from Zach.
Woody, inflation is getting really out of hand, but that's just my 5 cents. I think you choked to stifle a laugh.
I did. At the restaurant the other day, my server noticed that my glass was empty and asked, "Would you like another one?" And I said, "Why would I want two empty glasses?"
Fair enough.
Woody, how many M. Night Shyamalan movies does it take to change a light bulb?
How many?
Two. One to screw it in most of the way, and the other to give a surprise twist at the end.
Kind of saw that coming.
That was close, though.
That was cute. Jim, how do 37 mathematicians get on a bus that only holds 36?
Don't know.
They have to carry the one.
Oh.
Okay. That was brutal. That was terrible.
Yeah.
Woody, my mom has forbidden me from making any more breakfast puns.
Really?
She says if I do, I'm toast.
That was stupid, but it made me giggle.
Eventually, you just wear down. That's all that happens, right? Jim, I really got in touch with my inner self today.
Really?
I guess that means I need to start buying double-ply toilet paper.
Oh, no.
Didn't get a laugh, but a look of horror and disgust.
Are you surprised?
I'll take it.
Woody, I went... Did you just get it?
No.
Okay. Right. Woody, I went to a zoo that only had one animal.
Really?
And it was a dog. It was a shih tzu.
Jim, you know, poop jokes are not my favorite, but they are a solid number two.
Poop jokes get me every time.
Apparently, googly eyes Jim did not find that amusing. All right, here we go.
I smiled. I made a graph of all the relationships I've had. It had an x-axis and a y-axis.
Ah.
I don't get it.
It's kind of a y-axis.
Oh, W-H-Y.
All the best jokes need to be spelled out.
So true.
Explained.
So very true. Jim, I always want my girlfriend to wake up with a smile on her face. That was until she took away all my Sharpies.
You would actually do that.
Yeah, I would do that.
That almost got Jim.
I know.
Woody, I told my wife I wanted to be cremated. She made an appointment for Friday.
Friday?
No, it's just she wants it to happen right away.
Yeah, she wants it gone.
Oh, I thought it was a play on words with fry.
I guess it could work that way, too.
It could work that way.
It could.
Yes. Neither way is funny. Jim, speaking of death, Jim, I told my girlfriend that when I die, I want to die having sex.
Oh, my God.
And she said, well, at least it'll be quick. So close.
Okay.
So close.
My wife asked me to sink her phone, so I threw it in the ocean.
Sink. Oh, I gotta sink. Jim, why did Maximus, what did he do when the lion ate his wife?
I don't know.
He did nothing. He was gladiator.
Oh. You were on a roll there for a second, Woody.
I heard
that in other jokes. That's okay. What did one cannibal say to the other while they were eating a clown?
What?
Does this taste funny to you?
That's the one that
That's
got
the
you?
One.
No, it's always
wow,
the...
Wow, <It's... laughs> It wasn't even that funny.
He knows I love cannibalism and jokes about clowns.
I know. They're never funny.
All right.
That's the truth of this whole thing.
Oh, man.
Jim and his googly eyeglasses reign supreme, ladies and gentlemen.
Yay.
Thank you.
You have
you get an award.
Please text us 64895. Put WJ in the message and tell us which joke made you laugh while you were like driving or at your desk.
And you were ashamed to laugh.
And you were so mad at yourself.
And if it's none, just write none.
None.
They all sucked.
Yeah. And you can also, listen to the podcast later. It's out around lunchtime or so, the Woody and Jim Show podcast. And then you can just write all the jokes down and give them to your uncle.
It's time for men and women to answer questions for gender wars.
Representing the ladies the world over, we have Heather in Nashville. Good morning, Heather.
Good morning.
Good
Hello,
morning.
Sister.
Best of luck to you. For the guys, we have Gavin in Lebanon. Hello, Gavin.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey.
Great to have you. Let's do a get acquainted question. Gavin, what's the best advice you've ever been given?
Probably to be early instead of late.
Oh, I wish I followed that advice. Mm.
That's a thing that I should follow.
Yeah, no kidding.
What about Heather? What's the best advice you've ever been given?
Well, besides Zach telling me not to curse, when I was bartending, I had an older gentleman pull me aside who was a bartender forever, and he said, whatever you do, you're going to make a lot of money at 19. Whatever you do, don't drop out of school.
Oh.
Unfortunately, okay. I did not follow that advice.
Okay.
But that was the best advice I've gotten.
It was good advice you didn't follow.
Yeah. Which tends to be like everyone else.
Yeah,
we've all been there, Heather.
Easier said than done.
Exactly. All right. Remember, each of you have a screw you can use. If you don't know the answer to a question, you can make your opponent answer by yelling out, screw it before the buzzer.
Here we go. Multiple choice is how we start, Heather. First, second, or third. In baseball, which base is known as the hot corner?
Second?
No. Oh. Third base. Third base is the hot corner.
Okay. Oh, should have gone with that. Okay.
All right, Gavin, your turn. Is the dating show Too Hot to Handle seen on Fox, HBO Max, or Netflix?
HBO Max.
It's Netflix.
No Netflix, okay.
Right. Still 0-0.
No score yet. Here we go, Heather. How many of your opponent's boats do you have to sink to win a game of Battleship?
Oh, God. I don't think I played that since I was little. 9?
No, not that many. 5.
Just 5.
Just 5.
Sunk my Battleship.
I know.
All right. Maybe Gavin will be the first to get on the board.
What are you shopping for if you visit joanne.com, Gavin?
Crafting things?
Yes.
Fabrics, crafts. Good job.
Okay, that is the first right answer, which puts Heather in a precarious position. She's got to get this one right or the game is over.
Heather, who sings the theme song to NBC's Sunday Night Football?
Oh, is it Carrie Underwood?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Carrie Underwood. You've tied it up. Good job.
Got it. Now Gavin has a chance to win it if he gets this one right.
Retired NBA star Lamar Odom was once married to which Kardashian sister?
Khloe Kardashian.
Khloe.
Yes, exactly right.
You know your Kardashians. Well done.
Wow. Started off a little shaky, but then you guys warmed up
yeah.
and got your answers right. And Gavin is now the proud owner of tickets to go see Kane Brown.
Yeah, it's going to be a great concert.
Nice.
Nice show. You got it. You earned it. Let's do this again tomorrow morning at 7:20.
All right. So tell me what the olive theory is.
Okay. Well, it depends on, like, two people in a relationship and how they like or dislike olives. You want to elaborate, Ricki?
So basically, the olive theory is that you should always find somebody, if you like olives, who doesn't like olives.
Really?
So that you can have their olives.
Oh,
and vice
so
versa.
They'll be more for you because they don't like them.
But the idea is basically like opposites attract.
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah. you use an olive in that theory. So like if you're going out and you have a martini, like Zach and I love an extra dry martini, lots of olive juice,
yes.
with many olives in there. And if AJ really liked olives, then it would be like, ooh.
Your boyfriend.
That's a sign.
Liking olives just like you right. yes. mean that maybe your relationship isn't going to last.
Because maybe we're too similar.
Does okay. that mean David and I are going to break up?
I think that's exactly
like
what
olives?
It means.
Because
like
we
olives.
Both love olives and like blue cheese stuffed olives. Right. Love them. We so both love them.
Yeah, you're in danger.
So we're on the edge.
Bro.
My wife loves olives and I hate olives. So maybe that's the secret that, mm-hmm. you know, why we've been married so long is the
yeah.
whole olive thing.
I was always of the theory that you just find somebody who hates the same things you hate and you have that in common. You know, because my girlfriend Melissa, I said, I hate Pitbull. I do too. All right. We are a match made in heaven.
That's how I make friends.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not my relationships, but my friends. If we hate the same thing
yeah,
or the
yeah,
same the, person, it's
a solid
like,
relationship.
Ah,
yeah.
we're going to get along great.
We can get yeah. along great.
So, Woody, I know that you have, you eat olives, right?
Occasionally, yeah. Most,
yeah.
Mostly the black olives that you put on all your fingers at Thanksgiving. Yeah.
So
yes, that's exactly what you do with black olives.
That's what you got to do with them.
What about your girlfriend Melissa?
She likes them too.
Oh,
occasionally.
Uh-oh. Oh,
she does because when we were in Panama City Beach,
oh, yes.
I introduced her to an extra
to
dry
extra dirty martini.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They were alcohol soaked olives.
Yeah.
Yes.
Makes them even more delicious.
Uh-huh.
See, I like black olives. She likes the green olives. So
oh,
maybe,
okay.
Maybe
okay.
we will stay
there's
together.
There's a caveat.
There's some room there for possibilities.
There's a chance that love will bloom.
So you're saying there's a chance.
So I'm the only one on the brink of a breakup.
Yeah,
that's what
too
it looks
bad.
Like.
Darn.
Yeah. Now you guys had a good round.
I know.
You did all right
I'm
for
all
a while.
Lasting.
Yeah.
I still like to be friends with both of you.
Yeah.
If that's possible.
You can both? Still be friends with both of us.
I know
us.
When you yeah. get a divorce, you kind of split up the friends, but yeah.
Yeah, like, you know, I still like.
We'll try to be friends with both of you.
When you
perfect.
Break up.
When your inevitable breakup
when
happens.
We break up.
Yesterday in the mail, I got my cloud shoes. Not clown
oh.
shoes, but cloud shoes.
Does that mean they're like comfy cozy?
Yeah, they're really nice. It's supposed to be, you know, like people are on their feet all the time, like nurses and stuff like that.
Right. Oh,
these.
Fancy.
They're super light and really comfortable. So I thought I'd celebrate yesterday with my new shoes. It was such a nice day. I went out for a walk. Ended up twisting my knee. But,
that's good.
Yeah,
what were you
right.
doing on your walk that you twisted your knee?
Hopscotch.
makes sense.
That'll happen.
And you start off really rough this morning, Zach.
I did. I woke up this morning to a flat tire.
Oh, my
so
God.
So I had to change my tire in
oh
my,
my
garage this
manual
morning.
Manual labor.
It wasn't even the manual labor. It's the fact that it was so early in the morning that mm-hmm. I walk outside and that's the first thing
oh,
that
yeah.
I see. I was like, are you kidding
yeah.
me?
Yeah, my heart just
nice
drops.
Start.
But then things got better once you got to work, as you got a package in the mail.
Yes, I ordered us some studio socks
now
because
these,
I hate wearing shoes.
Now, are they actually called studio socks to wear
they
the
are
radio
now.
Studio?
That's what we're calling them.
It looks like they look like hospital socks, the ones that have little grippies
so,
on
yeah,
the bottom.
So yeah, they're essentially radio studio socks.
Okay.
We're in the hospital. We're
yes,
in the
that's right.
Essentially the same thing.
The hospital for the criminally insane.
Yeah, they kind of look like if you go to a trampoline park,
mm-hmm.
like the socks that you have to
yeah.
put on with the grippies on the bottom to go jump on the trampoline.
Right.
But they're fuzzy.
But they're fuzzy and super soft. So I bought them on Amazon because I hate wearing shoes. And I was like,
yes.
well, I don't want to get my socks dirty. So I need studio socks
mm-hmm.
to just, walk on this nasty ground.
That's would, right, because we have a carpet that's been here since like the 40s that has never been cleaned.
Yeah, there's... some objects in the carpet.
As you said earlier, Jim, you don't want to have a black light in here.
No.
No, you don't.
You sure don't. So
you want as much protection between your actual foot and the ground as possible.
Yeah, so Ricki and I are rocking our studio socks.
All right.
I just love fuzzy socks, so he got me at, they're fuzzy. I was like, yep, done deal.
You had me at fuzzy. I love that from Jerry Maguire.
You bought a lot of socks. You have like a 12-pack or something, didn't you? You were just like handing out socks like a
Santa
Claus. Yeah,
it's a big old pack of them. So if you want to put some on, you can.
I kind of feel left out of the sock club.
I think
you
should.
But then you can't make fun of the socks if you wear them.
Oh, sure I can.
No, you cannot.
Not if they're on your feet.
Nuh-uh. If they're on your feet, you cannot. No.
But then I'm making fun of myself. It's okay. Mm.
No. We pay good money for these socks. You can't make fun of them.
Experience the joy of socks, Jim.
Yes, you should.
They're quite delightful, honestly.
It's socksy time.
Am I prude if I don't want socks?
Yes.
107.5 The River with Woody and Jim in the morning. Pretty obvious that our planet hates us and is trying to get us back for all the terrible things we've done to it. Storms all over the nation, of course, there have been huge snowstorms. It's like they're saying the storm of a generation, of the week.
I know. It does seem like...
It's hard to say, this is the biggest thing that's ever happened when something bigger happens the next week.
Yeah.
But we're supposed to have some big old storms come through starting tonight.
We follow Nash Severe Weather on Twitter. It's probably the most reliable weather forecasting
They're the most realistic.
Right.
They're real.
And they're funny.
Yeah. So many of the TV stations are trying to frighten you and you're staying tuned, you know, like, right. Oh my God, something horrible is going to happen. But they're pretty honest about stuff.
Yeah, these are just like, you know, people who do weather for the sake of, like, the science and what's really going to happen, not trying to... you know, scare you and get ratings. So they usually call out the TV stations when they're saying, like, hey, these people are out of control. This is the real weather situation. So, but they are, so when they say something's coming that's kind of scary.
You can kind of take that to the bank, yeah.
Pay attention. They said round one of severe weather is tonight, damaging winds.
Mm.
Tomorrow in the morning, possibly hail.
Oh.
Round three is early Friday, everything's on the table. And they say, yes, Matilda, even tornadoes.
Mm.
And don't overlook flooding threats. So just be careful. Be safe, everybody.
Yeah, if you have a place to park indoors, you know, do that.
Yep, and don't drive through water.
Right, because you never know how deep it is.
They said more folks lose their life because of water than like high voltage or wind. So,
where do they always say, turn around, don't drown?
Exactly. Yes.
Exactly,
if you have no idea how deep it is, don't go through
it. Don't try.
Right. Yep. Right.
Not worth it.
Find another way or just go home.
Yeah.
All right. So be careful.
Thanks for listening to and recommending the Woody and Jim Show podcast. Listen to Woody and Jim in real time every weekday morning on 107.5 The River, Nashville, or live on the iHeartRadio app.